we saw you open in the scrying pool. What was inside, Jack?
Here!
Don't get distracted. Busted figure. A worshipped figure. The absolute gall of you to let yourself consider such a thing. I guess irony can have you when it earns you. Defying what the gods already possess. But what else, Kratos? Death and rebirth. Embrace the cycle. And things just got... Did you forget the taste of the factor here? I have one last weapon to show you. I think you'll enjoy it, if that's the word.
I don't usually get this close.
Great beard, by the way.
Continue.
I was in the fight of my life with the thugs who burned down my father's inn. Suddenly there's this sound, this flapping of feathers, and who should appear but Sigrun herself. Not yet queen, but by reputation, the best fighter the Valkyries had in memory. I was awestruck. She was confused. The violence, the mayhem she sensed, she expected to follow to a battlefield full of honored dead, not a hideout in the slums. I apologized to her for not sending worthier souls to Valhalla, and Sigrun offered to take me under her very impressive wing. But we'll cover that part next time, all right?
A substitute god. A box full of evils. This one feels important.
This is your blacksmith's story, isn't it? His girl was the key, and he died protecting her?
Protecting her from me. I opened that box seeking the means to kill Ares. And what I released...
Pretty much turned all the gods crazy. Thanks again for that.
Quiet, Ed.
Unfortunate. The time I spend in my own Valhalla means you get more time with him.
Kratos, how well did you know the blacksmith's daughter?
Pandora. She reminded me of my own daughter, who I lost long ago.
I'm sorry, Kratos. Even at your most vengeful, you must not have wanted to see harm come to her.
Pandora was innocent. The way she saw things, she could reach me when few could. She deserved better than to be a pawn, sacrificed in a game of gods.
Your regret is palpable. But thank you for letting yourself remember. That is important.
something's lost, not something's gained here.
Going to step back from the price Valhalla has asked me.
Good for you, Seagram.
I think maybe it's time I traveled. Experience these realms and the lands beyond, not as Valhalla's emissary, but as a person.
That's perfect. You've always dreamed of a grand sea voyage, seeing the world. Perhaps I could go with you. I've been told I'm a useful guide.
Perhaps. But let's not distract Kratos further.
Avoid that.
found the pendant of a necklace. Fancy.
I will tell you the pendant story soon.
I'm having a bit of a sinking feeling that Sigrun doesn't want me traveling with her.
You knew that before you asked.
Did I, brother?
You know the journey she seeks. It is the one you took, and I took. The kind that brings you to the test you need. The kind you take alone.
It's true. I gave in to her weakness. Even now, there's some part of me that just wants to tell her how much I love her and beg her to stay. Now that's bloody selfish. I need to do better than that.
I think I know why I fight your sons.
Do tell.
Like Atreus, they were children of a destroyer. And I lied. Changed. And I raised him as I was raised, subject only to authority. Perhaps his fate would have been no better than theirs.
So, they reflect a bad road not taken? Fate avoided?
Perhaps. I also feel pity. Failed by their father. Sent to die by their uncle and belittled in death by their grandfather. What chance did they ever have?
Am I feeling guilt, brother?
Some. Perhaps imagining a fair fight is to honor them as life did not.
The pendant you found, brother. Do you recognize it? Does it have some significance?
Yes. It belonged to my wife.
It was Faye's.
No. My first wife, Lysandra.
Ah, I see. You know, brother, you've told me a great deal about your daughter, Calliope. But her mother is a bit of a mystery.
My thoughts on her are complicated. She was a good woman, and I loved her more than she knew. She saw in me possibilities I could not at the time. That way, she and Faye were much alike.
Specific beats that Valhalla is prepared to reward, is it?
You're not done with me yet, Kratos. Behind you, dummy! All your righteous haranguing about how evil the gods are, and you somehow gloss over that little extra nudge you gave them.
Opening the box was Athena's plan. I did not know the consequences.
You would claim ignorance of the consequences of trusting Athena? Is that your idea of a joke, Kratos? Because I admit it's hilarious. But let's be real, Kratos. Whether you should have suspected the consequences or not, you certainly can't claim that you would have cared about them. You wanted the power to kill Ares. And because you wanted it, everything is justified. That's your moral code at the end of the day, isn't it? To imagine you once again holding an office of solemn metaphysical responsibility. A trusted figure. A worshipped figure. The absolute gall of you to let yourself consider such a thing. I guess irony can have you when it earns you, or something. Oh, how precious. I don't think you could be trusted to keep that safe at all. Pretty sure he agrees with me. Quickly!
Oh!
ball of light heading straight for us! The one that needed getting and gotten. Aren't you swell? Glowy one before it closes in. Did you forget the case of the factor here? Right flank! Incoming dive! Wrong weapon, man! Behind you, idiot! Charge! Valhalla salutes your commitment to violence. Incoming dive! Just a bunch of kill-thirsty reprobates you can't seem to get out of your mind.
Hello again, Kratos. I have one last weapon to show you. I think you'll enjoy it, if that's the word.
Last thing I told you was that I'd become an apprentice to a mage healer of renown. I learned much from her, not just about the healing arts, but about how to live a complete life, a whole life, true to yourself. She was like a mother to me, which made it all the more painful when she too fell ill. It was the same illness that had taken my father. But this time would be different. It was my chance to apply everything she taught me to try and save her. Anyway, I think that's a...
Proceed.
Sigrun, mightiest of the Valkyries, saw me in action and thought I had potential. Wanted to train me in the ways of the Sisterhood, but I wasn't so sure. A knack for violence is one thing, but serving a higher cause, taking on the responsibility of choosing the slain, me, Gunnar of Blackheart Alley? For once, I hesitated. I couldn't make myself believe it. But Sigrun told me to put everything out of my mind but the work. Mastering each new skill. Discovering what I was truly capable of through discipline and focus. Letting excellence be its own reward. Really opened my eyes. But we'll wrap it up next time, okay?
That's wife Lysandra. She said she saw possibilities in you that you didn't.
She suggested I did not have to be who I had chosen to be. That the carnage and suffering I inflicted on those my army conquered was a choice. That there was another way. I refused to see it then, thinking it was my duty to annihilate all that stood in the way of the Spartan Empire. I believed leaving foes alive simply invited potential uprisings later. That enemies could never be turned to friends. I was wrong.
Yeah.
flat on your back!
Welcome back, Kratos.
Speak.
If you'll remember, my teacher had fallen ill. Everything she taught me, I poured into trying to save her. But it turned out mage healing wasn't enough. I realized that only a combination of mage healing and herbal traditions could save her. But I'd let my knowledge of the herbal arts fade away. And so, I failed her like I failed him. And she passed into Hell's embrace. It took a long time to get over that. Anyway, I'll stop here for now.
Lysandra's pendant again. I suspect your story isn't complete.
Yes, but...
I know. Later.
Any questions as you go?
I've won. We were told only those who had died could enter Valhalla. But I don't ever recall hearing when you died.
A bit of a technicality, to be honest. It involved a workaround to regain the arm Garm bit off. Really only glancingly involved the underworld, but Valhalla seems to count on, I suppose.
Lysandra was clearly important to you. Why did you say your feelings for her were complicated?
Because she was a good wife, and I was not a good husband. I refused to listen, to heed her advice. I commanded armies, had responsibilities to them I thought greater than those to her. But that was hubris and ambition. The truth is, it never even crossed my mind to consider her advice or needs. So, when I keep her safe, I can only see my failures. She deserved better from me. And that was long before my oath to Ares led to...
all that was to follow. I understand, brother.
Kratos, you made it back.
Good.
Come on! On your right!
I didn't catch
fight!
Welcome back, Kratos.
Defend yourself. be a centaur. Hostile one, it seems.
Come on! Good! I'd expect nothing less. Closer to ready. Good to see you again, Kratos.
Yeah! I see you, Kratos. One of a kind. Be ready. Great beard, by the way.
Be ready.
Stop, Kratos. I yield.
Hard fought.
Let's see what your mind has worked out. When the evils of the box were purged, what remained was hope, which you chose to release back to the world.
Yes. After everything, you came back full circle to sacrificing yourself.
My death would have been just, but it was not to be.
Yes, you lived, and hope still lived inside you, from that day to this one. One might say you brought hope back to these realms after a long slumber. Box or no box, Kratos, hope and fear and love and hate exist in every one of us. The question is, which will you choose to let guide your actions? Each choice we make shapes our world.
I see the truth of it.
And?
I believe I am ready to walk through that door.
Excellent.
Suffering, of destruction. And Owen said I chase redemption that I know I can never deserve. What does that make me? A god of fools. A god of... Everything and everyone. You became... There is no forgiving you. You chose! Should I this same man? Should I sit, take, proclaim, lead, place myself in service?
Like I missed everything. Did you find what you needed? Glad to hear it, brother. Well done here then. So, what now?
No. I believe. I would like to sit here for a while.
Thank you.
Well done, General. I had no doubt you would see this through to the end. Congratulations. I hope Valhalla gave you everything you needed. Look who's returning from the front gate. Something must have happened in there.
I take it this is a good sign.
I will join you. I will try to be what the people need.
Good. I'm very pleased to hear that. And that you found what you needed here.
I could not have done so without my friends. I am grateful.
Valhalla is at your disposal, Kratos. If you have more you wish to work out, now or later, we will heed the call.
Continue.
As you recall, I failed my teacher and wasn't able to save her life. I'd let my aversion to my father's traditions stop me from being able to adapt to circumstances. After that, I spent many winters reconstructing his teachings, integrating them into my arsenal. I realized how important it was for me to practice techniques that don't come easy to me, or even ones I have every reason to hate and reject. Because then I'm armed for everything. Then I can adapt to whatever life throws at me. Anyway, that's my story.
Thank you, Air. I understand.